Hello everyone, my name is Toby and welcome back to Stray. Now you may be wondering, why does my voice sound so weird? Why is it not matching up with what I'm showing on the webcam? My mic was turned off during the recording of this. So, I am doing what they call in the industry as a voiceover. I will give you a little bit of commentary on what I can remember that I was going on about. Let's see how this goes, shall we? It's the facial expressions for me. This is where I'm saying this drone reminds me of the one from Soma. This little guy. But now it also reminds me of this one from Flubber. This is where I admire the realism of the harness cat. This is the part where I nerd out over having an inventory as a cat! This is where I nerd out that I have a flashlight as a cat! This is the part where I waste time looking for things. You know, the new favorite hobby I do. It's like, you know, you set your keys down and you can never remember where you found them because you just laid them down in a random spot, not usually where you would locate things. That's about how I am with trying to find things in video games. Yeah. We'll get there eventually. We will see it eventually. It's not going to be in the last place that we look. Probably not, because we already looked in the last place about 18,000 times. But we will find it one day. We have this much faith in ourselves. This does not fit the commentary that I'm giving on this part, but honestly, I don't remember anything that I said. So why not? Right? Yeah, this is how we do things whenever we have technical difficulties. Yeah, innovation. We think way outside of the box. The box is being held by our costumes. This is the part where I point out that the iron need to go up, you have to go down. That has never made any sense to me, but it makes sense to everyone else, and I really
don't get that. It's like the logic. I don't get it. Yeah. This is the part where my brain works before the game tells me. This is a very exciting moment in my life, because usually I don't pick up on these things as quickly as this, but I did in this moment. Yay me! This was the first moment that I knew I had just made a mistake. I'm really glad that you cannot hear me as I'm screaming through this, but I had realized that that had a translate deal above the sign as I was ziplining through that. So yeah. Yeah, this is the point where I gave up on life and everything, and I decided to restart and rethink my choices that I have made. This is the part where I remembered to set my timer. We are at 13 minutes into this game, and I am choosing now to do this. This is the part where I was testing out no such thing as a locked door around a cat method, and that method did not work, and I just want to know, has anyone asked the actual cats about this? This is the part where I realized I had learned nothing from my first chance. It's like I just went in and redid the same thing twice. This was the part where I was giving the cat a personal pep talk. I was telling the cat, you know, I got your back as long as it's got my back. I'll keep a lookout for it. That I know I'm very slow, but we have this. It'll be okay. That we got this. And I think the cat was in agreement because he did in fact meow a few times in response. So I am taking that as that we have made an agreement. This is the moment where I became very alarmed because my presence triggered that alarm and I didn't know what was going to happen to me. I mean, I'm only a cat. I do have claws. Yes, I do keep them sharp every time I come across, you know, a carpeted area or wooden plank. I do sharpen them, but sometimes it's just not enough. This is the moment I thought I was going to have to fight a robot samurai as a cat. Again, I only have sharp claws. I mean, he is made of wiring, but I'm going to have to get through that shell somehow. This is the part where I calmly explain that I am not a vampire cat and therefore will be eating no one. His alarm is not required nor necessary. Be glad you didn't get to hear my terrible robot voice impressions. That's all I got for this one. This is the part where I nerd out that B12, who I nicknamed Vitamin 12, gives me my objectives, because honestly, how cool is that? This is the part where I make a joke about giving a cat an energy drink and make a reference to this guy. If you know, you know. Points if you get the reference. This is the moment I realized my zoomies was so much faster, and I told the cat that I was going to end up whamming it into a wall, and that's exactly what happened, but it's the satisfying thunk for me. This is the part where I make a ridiculous pun about curiosity killing the cat due to the achievement that unlocked. And this is the part where I get excited thinking I might be able to play the rest of the game with a bag on my head. And that's when disappointment happened. This is the part where I get mistaken for a metal-eating creature. It's the harness, isn't it? Yeah, I knew it would send the wrong message. So this is the part where I thought the barman was the burger man. I took it as a whimsical play on words, and apparently I was way off, because his name be Jacob. how human is that robot named Jacob? But then again, the one by the vending machine that told us about this dude, I mean, his name was Teddy, so, alright, it be that way. Dear Diary, this thing, this cat, is being protected by an invisible shield. Try as I might, I cannot break through. In this moment, we are presented with my confusion, acting like I have any idea of anything being said in this whatsoever. This is the part where I reload my weaponry and make sure that all of my guns and ammunition are A-OK. But since we are a cat, we are just sharpening 10 claws. Jacob, you worked really hard to earn this. You're the best barman we've ever seen. This was the moment I realized that was a directional sign and not just there for decoration. I should actually follow that if I wanted to get to where I'm going. So in this moment, as you will see, the guy on the left, who is blue of face, is clearly waving my catness over there, and I clearly did not get that social interaction.
How much, Queen? What? It's for the wife. Oh, 20 shekels. Right. What? There you are. Wait a minute. Well, we're supposed to haggle.
No, no, I've got to get...
What do you mean, no?
I haven't got time.
Well, give it back then.
No, I just paid you.
Huh? Yeah.
This bloke won't haggle.
Won't haggle?
All right, do we have to? Now, look, I want 20 for that.
I just gave you 20.
Now, are you telling me that's not worth 20 shekels?
No.
Look at it. For your equality, that's not in your goat.
All right, I'll give you 19 then.
No. Come on, do it properly.
What?
Haggle properly. This isn't worth 19.
You just said it was worth 20.
Oh, dear. Come on, haggle.
All right, I'll give you 10.
That's more like it. 10? Are you trying to insult me? Me with a poor dying grandmother? 10?
All right, I'll give you 11.
Now you're getting it. 11? Did I hear you right? 11? This cost me 12. You want to ruin me?
17?
No. 17.
18?
No, you're going to 14 now.
All right, I'll give you 14.
14? Are you joking? That's what you told me to say.
Oh, dear.
Oh, tell me what to say, please.
Offer me 14.
I'll give you 14. He's offering me 14 for this.
15.
17. My last word. I won't take a penny less or strike me dead. 16. Done.
This is the part where me and the cat got into a discussion about how far it could really jump. Now, the level of audacity that this cat was using in the base of its meow in this discussion leads me to believe that I am absolutely correct in the fact that this cat can make the longer jumps. It just chooses not to. This is the part where the cat informs me it is done with me, and this is the part where I tell the cat I am indeed done with myself as well. So I am giving the cat reassurance and validation on the fact that this cat is not alone with its opinion in that aspect. This is the part where the cat got attitude because of the high jump. I merely told the cat that it was built for jumps like this. This is exactly why it has 9 lives. I don't think we came to any sort of agreement on that, but I know I'm right. This is the part where I gushed over the cuteness of this cat. I'm very glad that you could not hear me. It was really embarrassing. Ooh, big stretch! This is the part where I told the cat it was fine. It had that jump. This is the part where I saw the pattern in the game that's in all games, that's even in life. If I take the bucket, I go back down. I'm trying to go up. Once again, the cat is fine. It's just overdramatic. It was in this moment that we finally understood why curiosity, in fact, killed the cat. I will seek myself out. This was the moment that made the cat turn into a cat thief for the barter system. This was his pivotal moment in his own heroic story. Thank you. This is the sound that literally everyone makes when they're washing dishes and someone brings a dirty dish to them and they're almost halfway done doing dishes. Literally everyone everywhere makes this noise. That meow was the cat accepting my apology for making it to that high jump. This is me realizing I did in fact make the wise choice in getting the sheet music when I was there and had the energy drink. So, go me. I was right for once. This is the moment we chose to lay down, relax, listen to a jaunty tune, not at all still be angry over the fact that past Toby didn't check the mic setup, so now present Toby has been spending the last 2 hours of his life correcting past Toby's mistake, and that is on the list of reasons why we are constantly angry at past Toby, number 1,824 million, probably. But do we ever learn? No, we don't. We just keep going and going. And that is the cycle that we call life. And now we wake up from our little nap and carry on. This is the moment where I'm trying to figure out why I don't have a PIN number to this safe. Why I think I would have a PIN number to this safe, and why I think it would be anywhere. I have no idea. But yet, here we are. Me pointing out to the robot that is way smarter than me that obviously that code goes with that safe. Me proving I am not smarter than the robot. What happens if it starts raining? Are we, as a cat, going to freak out over the raindrops as it's hitting us while we're climbing up the obstacles from the sides of the buildings? Or are we some type of super cat because we have a harness and the raindrops don't bother us because we are above cat-like and are not scared of the water? Or maybe we're a cat robot. Maybe that is how the cat instinctively knows how to go after batteries. Maybe? What are your thoughts? What are your theories? But please, no spoilers. No spoilers at all. I want to see if the cat becomes a stray that's adopted by a robot, or a stray that's adopted by a robot. I want to know these things, but I want to learn them myself. So please, no spoilers. that moment when you first heard Momo name and your first thought was mom in a kimono, and you finally meet Momo and you find out it's a robot in a Hawaiian flamingo shirt, and you are not disappointed at all. This is the most cheerfully dressed character we have run into, and he is the one preaching so much about bad omens. Makes you wonder, don't it? This is where I point out the hilariousness that one of the robots is named Doc. I see what you did there. I am almost out of time for this episode, so I jabber on aimlessly for 20 more seconds, repeating myself continuously, because I don't rehearse anything before I do it. This is why Past Toby should not be winging things, said by Present Toby. But I will see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye!